Dear students, today we are going to discuss a new topic, Sustainable Development, chapter number 12. Now, before going to understand exactly what is meaning of sustainable development, let us try to understand certain basic concepts. Because once you are familiar with these concepts, then you can understand what exactly is meaning of sustainable development in detail. First thing, as you know, you are all familiar with the concept of national income. You have been studying in 8th and 9th standards. National income, that is the income earned by all the citizens of the country in one particular financial year. The put together, that is called national income. National income can be calculated in different methods. Product method, income method, output method, and etc. Now, before going into that, how to derive per capita income? Per capita income is an average income which is earned by a citizen of a country. How do we get this per capita income? Per capita income is derived by national income divided by population. So, X is the amount of national income divided by whatever is the population of that country, then we derive per capita income. So, per capita income is a very essential indicator of economic development of the country. We can exactly analyze country stands where. Is the country developed country, developing country, or underdeveloped country? So, per capita income is one of the major indicator for the development. But other than per capita income, we have another indicator called as HDI, Human Development Index, which is a social indicator. Now, what exactly is the Human Development Index? Human Development Index studies not only the economic status, production status of a country, but also what it does is, it also calculates the other facilities which the citizens are availing, the socio-economic facilities, that is the education, the literacy rate, the sex race, the housing ratio, the urbanization ratio, and all these factors put together, the development indicator is called as Human Development Index. Human Development Index, as you know, was coined by Professor Amartya Sen, the great economist of India, and he was even awarded Nobel Prize for this particular invention. Now, in this defining the term of Human Development Index, we can analyze whether the country's standard, what it stands in compared with other countries. So, Human Development Index is one of the major indicator for the development. Not only it sees the economic growth, but it sees what are the basic minimum facilities does the citizen of that country enjoys. Now, this is what is major important aspect when you judge A country is developed or a B country is developed. You should not see only the per capita income of the country. You should also see the rank of HDI of that country, which will give you a clear picture the citizen of that country is availing which kind of facilities, what is the literacy rate in that country, what is the ratio of urbanization, what is the ratio of development in that country related to the social aspects, and all these factors are taken up in the Human Development Index. We have one more indicator called as gross domestic product. So, gross domestic product is nothing but the total production by all the factors of production when it is involved by all the three sectors, primary, secondary and tertiary sector put together, is called GDP of a country in one particular academic year. So, in financial year. So, coming on to the factor, why exactly we cannot take per capita income as an indicator of economic development? The reason behind this is what? Per capita income, which will show us only the economic status in which the high section of the population is involved and low section of the population is involved and middle section of the population is involved. So, it can't give a clear picture whether the country is developed or developing. But whereas Human Development Index studies in detail and analyzes every citizens and are all the citizens are well within the reach of literacy rate or within the reach of education, health, sanitation and all other facilities. So, let us try to analyze why exactly even though some countries per capita income is very high, the economic development or socio-economic development of the country is very poor. Like if you take the best example is India. Even though we say that our per capita income is increasing year on year and we are saying that we are aspiring country and we are developing to some extent, if you see the workforce in the country is unorganized or not properly distributed. Out of total 100% of workforce of our country, 90% of the workforce is in unorganized sector and 10% of the workforce is in organized sector. Now here children, you need to understand what's meaning of organized and unorganized sector. Organized sector means the sector which has well-planned development, the sector where the employment opportunities are given in industries. They have standard pattern of income, they have standard pattern of living and they get regular income on regular basis. They have coverage of insurance, they have coverage of health facilities and etc. They come under organized sector. Unorganized sector are the people, those who organize themselves in other activities like daily vendors, self-employed people, you know, all these people, those who don't have a regular source of income, they depend on only on market forces or market activities and they don't have any regular source of income, like inconsistency is not there in their income, they come under unorganized sector. Now what exactly happening in India is 90%, the major chunk of population is involved in unorganized sector. Now this is what is very uncertainty and this is a sign of again not exactly development we can say, because only 10% of the people or so called people population is workforce is engaged in organized sector. Even though we say that India is highly populated country and the workforce of India is more, as India is called the youngest country in the world where the population group between 16 to 60 is more. But unfortunately, the productive age group is also involved more in unorganized sector, as a result of which India suffers socially and in a socio-economic status, if you try to gather for India, the socio-economic status of India will be low. Why exactly? Let us try to analyze in detail. The people who are working in unorganized sector will be low paid. There is no guarantee of regularity of their income. Maybe today, a example you can take the groceries person, those who is selling vegetables or any groceries or etc. So today they may sell all their groceries, or tomorrow there is a day where there is no person buying their groceries. So there is uncertainty with regard to unorganized sector. The standard of living also of these people is very poor, not up to the mark, and they are even deprived of certain basic minimum necessities like food, clothing and shelter. And another thing is what? They comes under have-nots category of the society. Have-nots nothing but economically poor section of the society. Whereas organized sector, the people, those who are engaged in all software firms and the BPOs and etc. and huge companies or large scale companies, they have regular source of income and they have standard pattern of living, they have standard pattern of income, etc. Like they have better standard of living compared to unorganized sector people. They have high incomes and they are called as haves or the rich people of the society. Now, let us try to analyze in detail. If you really analyze the pyramid-wise division or pyramid-wise structure of exactly the workforce or the people in the country, you'll be understanding it more clearly. Nearly 135 million of population comes under deprived section of the society because they have income less than 1.5 lakh per annum. Whereas 71 million population comes under the second category from down. They are called as aspirers. They want to grow economically and they want to develop economically stronger. Their income falls under 1.5 to 3.4 lakhs per annum. The next category is middle class. 3.4 to 17 lakhs per annum is the income, and there are 31 million people who are coming under this bracket. Only 3 million people, the handful of people, they come under the rich section of the society where their income is more than 17 lakhs per annum. Now this pyramid itself gives us a clear picture that the major chunk of the population lies in the deprived and aspirer sections of the society. And so called the rich section of the society caters only 3 million of the total population. And this indicates that the economic development is not percolating down. The growth is not percolating down. The development is only at the peak level. Rich are becoming richer, whereas poor are becoming poorer. Even after 66 years of our independence, we are still in this particular situation, which indicates that economic development is not uniform. There is a lot of unfair distribution of resources, unfair distribution of employment opportunities is happening with regard to economic status. Children, now let us try to understand case by case a relationship between development and environment. Now, as you know, children, development never cares for environment, and protection of environment cannot be possible if you really aspire for growth, modernization, high tech you want to become, or you want to develop your cities in a more ultra modern ways. As you know, children, whenever we discuss about development, always the environmentalist question us, how can you achieve this development?